Hello, this is going to be a very quick video just to introduce you to a product if you're not aware of them. When you charge your phone up at an unknown charging point, where it might be on a bus, at a cafe, or at a public charging station, they have sometimes little boxes where you can open it up, put your phone in, plug it in, lock it, and come back in half an hour. Whatever it is, hackers can actually, if they're not wired absolutely perfectly to prevent data, those unknown charging points can be used by hackers to put malware, like viruses and things, on your phone. They can sometimes steal data off your phone, take all your pictures and your notes and everything. Or they can just creepily act as if they're a monitor, like a TV, and just watch what you're doing on your phone. And one of the easiest ways to prevent this is to have a data blocker. This is the one I've had for quite some years. So this is an old model. And what it does is inside it doesn't have the wiring for the data aspect. So you can see in there's all the pins in there. But the ones for the data aren't actually connected. And it has a chip in there to be able to have some form of fast charging, because it can sense if it's an Android or if it's an iOS device. So I wanted a newer one, so I went with this one. Now, this is a very basic model. It does not have the chip that can sense what type of device it is, so it doesn't have any specific fast charge capability. But what they've done with these newer models, as you can see, there's only two pins. It physically does not have the necessary pins to transmit data. And it actually has the word in the middle there where the pins would be, and it says no data. It's kind of difficult to see on the camera. I think you can just about see it there. No data. So this physically blocks all data. So you would plug this into the charging point, maybe on the bus like I do, and then you plug your normal cable in here, and all that will happen is power gets transmitted to your phone. Now, I didn't fully read the description for this, and I wasn't fully aware that this was like a cut down model that has no chip. I wanted what I had with my old one, where it can sense the type of device and give me some form of faster charging capability. So I ordered this one. Now, this one's a little battered, it's been in a bag, but this is the same thing. It's the third generation model, but this one does have the chip, the same as the old one did. That also has a chip, but as you can see, that one's got all the wires. So if you were to just look at it, you wouldn't know for sure, to be able to prove to yourself without a shadow of a doubt, that when they say they're blocking data, that they are. Whereas this one, a simple visible check, you can just literally see that the pins are missing for the data. So that's what really sets this one apart. So it's a very simple device. They're very cheap, like £4.50. I think they make black ones, which are £5, which I really wish I'd have bought. But just, they're so handy. So what I've done is I've bought myself a short USB to USB-C cable to be able to charge my phone up, and I just leave this one. I have another one that I've got in a pocket organizer that I carry with me, but just for convenience, I permanently leave this one connected to this cable, so that when I'm on the bus, it's hard to do with one hand, but it's always connected, so when I go on the bus, I can just plug that into the bus socket, plug the other end into my phone, and it's charging up while I'm listening to my music. So just before we go, this is the little leaflet you get with it. So if you want to have a quick read of that, you can pause the video and have a look. So there's some information for you. So there you go. It's very simple, but extremely useful. So if you have phones or tablets or anything, and you do want to charge while you're out and about using other sources of power, get yourself one of these. Seriously, you don't want to have your data hijacked or have someone watching you type in your credit card number while you're buying things, etc., etc. So there you go. If this video has been useful, please like, subscribe, and I'll see you on whatever the next video happens to be about. Thank you.